Continue Google Cloud Dataflow's last minute cheat sheet. I went through how Dataflow works in the last video. Now let's take a look at the key points on how to build a Dataflow pipeline. Dataflow is built on Apache Beam. You use Apache Beam SDKs to define both batch and streaming data parallel processing pipelines. Let's take a look at an example of Google Provider Templates pipeline before we move to the key concepts of Apache Beam program models. Let's select text files on cloud storage to BigQuery template to understand the pipeline. The pipeline encapsulates your entire data processing task from start to finish. This includes reading input data, transforming that data, and writing output data. The first step is to read text files from cloud storage. Beam comes with a number of I/O library ptransformers to read and or write data to various external storage systems. If you click the transform task, you will see the data processing operation or step in this example Purdue, which is called ptransform. The distributed data set that your Beam pipeline operates on is called pcollection. You can click each step, then you will see the linear pipeline, branch pipeline, and the merge pipeline in this example. I put the abstract diagrams here for you to remember the key terms in the pipeline, pconnection, ptransform, and IO transforms that we just went through in the exam template. When you design a pipeline, you can choose the pipeline from linear pipeline, branching pipeline, or merging pipeline, or a composition pipeline with all three types like we saw in the exam. Also, the list of transform operations with one sentence summary for the exam. You can pause the video to go through the transform operations in Apache Beam's documentation. In all the core transformers, I want to highlight the Purdue for the exam. When you apply a Purdue transform, you will need to provide a user code in the form of a DoFun object. DoFun is a Beam SDK class that defines a distributed processing function. You can use Purdue to filtering a dataset, formatting or converting the type of each element in a dataset, extracting parts of each element in a dataset, and performing computations on each element in a dataset. I will go through how to aggregate elements in unbounded collections through windows, watermarks, and triggers in the next video. Thanks for watching, and as always, subscribe to my channel for more great cloud computing learning tips. See you next time.